Hey everyone, it's Angela at HealthyLivingChick.com, and today I'm sharing with you a little about exercise and muscle strength. If you want to keep your muscles as you age, you need to use them or you're going to lose them. And today I'm going to reference Dr. Joseph Pacola and just tell you a little bit about his article that he wrote about muscular strength. And as we age, our muscles start to atrophy, which means we start to lose those. If you've ever remember going to grandmother's house, then you saw muscle atrophy when you had her lift your arm and you were able to really wiggle waggle it. And we want to keep that firm. If you don't use it, you're going to lose it. And we want to work our muscles regularly. We don't want to go for a long time without using our muscles and then all of a sudden use our muscles and, you know, overwork them, because that causes scar tissue, especially as we get older. So we want to go gently and easily, but we want to keep that momentum. You want to do it 2 to 3 days a week, every single week. Also, additional benefits for muscle strength is combat heart disease, combat osteoporosis, but along with that, we want to eat whole foods. As we get older, our bones become dense and brittle. So to combat all of this, we need to just continue our exercise of our strength training. I know we can use this information with clients that just want to age gracefully, and just to keep encouraging them 2 to 3 days a week, just to put a few pounds in their hand. Doesn't have to be bodybuilding. I don't know, when I'm at the grocery store and I see people laying like this, then I want to sit up even more, because I don't want to be that hard. Our scripture for today is, do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. You were bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your body. 1 Corinthians 6:19-20. And in this verse, we see that the God of the universe, or, you know, the one that created all things, actually lives and dwells within us. And in order to do the work that we are here purposed for, we can honor God with our body, because the Holy Spirit lives in us, and we want to show others the love of Jesus. And how can we do that if we're sick, unhealthy, and in pain? Hey everyone, I'm back today because I wanted to also address flexibility. And as we age also, we want to flex the body in different ways, and realize the body only flexes in so many ways. And I'm going to talk a little bit about a controversial subject within Christianity called yoga. And I got this information from Holy and Healthy Living. This article is written by Rhonda with ChristianHealthOnline.com. Yoga. What is yoga? Because people in Christianity, I have clients that we have these discussions or that won't even go here. And so let's just talk about it. What is yoga? Yoga is moving the body in certain ways in order to stretch with flexibility, in order to build strength, because you're building strength with your own self. And some other benefits are the slow moving, deep breathing. You're actually reducing your stress. You're calming yourself down. You're reducing your negative emotions. And you're able to meditate on God. A lot of yoga practices now associate with holy yoga, or put scriptures in, or they have a form of worship as to our Christian God, our God. We can also strengthen our muscles, but the one thing that I love about yoga is that it increases flexibility, and as we age, we get stiffer over time, and we need to increase our flexibility. Our coordination and balance starts to waver as we get older, and we want to keep that. So if we do a couple of days of strength training, or increasing our muscle strength with specific yoga poses that increases muscle strength, then you can also do it this way as well. But we want to increase flexibility, increase strength, as well as doing cardio work, which is another video. But the benefits of yoga is supporting back pain. How many people have had low back pain? Or any kind of pain, soothing muscles, reducing our symptoms of menopause. And yoga can support our body in so many ways if we just have a different outlook. Devil means for evil, God can redeem it. I think that could be in anything. It's all in how we apply it into our life, as well as who we're worshiping and what we're doing. But remember, the body can only move in so many ways. We can use this information for clients that struggle with pain. It could be chronic pain, it could be low back pain, because movement is key in health. And so I call it movement. We live a sedentary lifestyle. So we want to increase our movement and increase our flexibility and our strength. Thank you and have a great day.